हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू विष्णु आईएएस यूट्यूब चैनल। सो माय नेम इज अंजी, सीसैट पेपर टू फैकल्टी हियर। आई हैव नियरली 8 इयर्स एक्सपीरियंस इन दिस इंडस्ट्री। सो आई एम टीचिंग सीसैट पेपर टू फ्रॉम लास्ट 8 ईयर ऑनवर्ड्स। सो हियर वी विल फोकस मेनली कंप्लीट डिटेल्स ऑफ ईपीएससी सीएससी प्रिलिमिनरी सीसैट पेपर टू सिलेबस एनालिसिस एंड प्रिपरेशन स्ट्रेटजी, एंड पर्टिकुलरली वी विल फोकस ऑन टिप्स ऑल्सो। सो जनरली whenever we are preparing for UPSC CSE, general studies paper 1 is obviously very very important, but some students are neglecting CSAT paper 2. But we cannot neglect, because in a CSAT exam, that is in a preliminary level, paper 1 important, along with that paper 2 is also very very important. We cannot neglect this paper, because once you clear this paper 2, then only your paper 1 will be evaluated. But this paper 2 obviously is a qualifying in nature. At least you have to score minimum 33% of marks. But how to score the 33% of marks in very less time and very easily, very simple way, we'll discuss complete details, and particularly we will focus CSAT paper 2 complete analysis. Syllabus analysis is very very important, guys. Once you understand what topics are there, what is the actual syllabus, we'll see. And along with that, we will discuss whenever you are in the journey of UPSC preparation, or particularly for prelims CSAT paper, what preparation steps we have to use. That points we'll discuss here. We'll try to understand first what is a plan of examination in the UPSC. The first, if you observe prelims level, it's a complete objective MCQ type of questions you will get. In a stage 2, you'll find complete written type of examination, descriptive type. And the final stage is interview or personal test, personality test. So these are the main three important stages here. One by one we will understand, but particularly in this session, we'll specifically focus on CSAT paper 2 analysis. Let's see here. If you observe, preliminary examination consists two papers, that is general studies of paper 1 and general studies paper 2. Particularly CSAT. So civil services aptitude test. So generally, so why civil services introduce this particular test? That is obviously very very important. So whenever you are writing these kind of exams, we require some kind of abilities and attitude. So aptitude test, that is we are learning from this particular CSAT test, that is in the paper 2. But in this particular case, preliminary examination, so both are objective type in nature, but particularly CSAT paper 2 consists only 80 questions, but just focus on here 200 marks. Compared to paper 1, in the paper 2, each question carries 2.5 marks. So here, very very important thing, in a general studies paper 1, it consists 100 marks, 100 questions and 200 marks. The both consist of 2 hours time, but particularly you have to focus on negative marks are there. Here negative marks are there for both the sections and both the papers, that is 0.33. But particularly in general studies paper 2, very clearly you have to focus, otherwise you will have a problem. That is, in the general studies paper 2, that is CSAT, we have 80 questions and 200 marks. Each question carries generally here 2.5 marks, that is negative marks also higher compared to this paper 1. So that's why very clearly, if you are specifically you are getting the right answer, then only you have to answer. Otherwise, we cannot attempt that type of questions. But particularly if you follow my strategy, my analysis of the syllabus, definitely we can score very good marks. We'll forward to that points here. But before going to that, just observe in the mains examination, what are the syllabus and what are the subjects are there. If you observe particularly, in here, in the mains paper, you will find starting paper A and paper B, both are this qualifying papers, we can call generally. In the qualifying papers, so in a paper A, just we can take as a particularly any Indian language you can take here, and a paper 2 compulsory English. So these are the papers you will get in a qualifying in papers, and remaining all are considered as a mains paper. That is, we have essay, and we have general studies 1 to general studies 4. So all these are general studies papers, as well as we have optional subjects also. That we'll see very clearly here. If you observe, first two are the qualifying papers, then we have GS papers including essay, and the final one is optional paper 1 and paper 2. These are the total papers in the mains examination. But a preliminary exam, is different, and mains exam is completely, it's a descriptive type of thing, and sort of final merit list based on this mains marks. So definitely we have to score very good marks, that's okay, but particularly we are focusing on today CSAT paper 2 complete preparation analysis and syllabus analysis. So these are the total stages, guys, in the mains level and interview process, the qualifying papers, an essay paper, and general studies paper 1 to paper 4, as well as we have optional, the paper 1 and paper 2, and the final stage is interview or personal details. These are the stages in the mains level and a personal details interview. But today's main important thing in this particular class, in this session, is we are focusing on CSAT paper 2 analysis, that is the preliminary level points we'll see. In the prelims, we already seen paper 1 and paper 2, both the papers are there. General studies 1, syllabus is this one. Clear? So all these points, everyone knows that whenever you are preparing for UPSC CSE preliminary exam, first you have to focus in a paper 1. All these topics are very, very important. Scoring marks in paper 2, obviously very, very important, because in a preliminary level, if you want to clear or if you want to score that cutoff marks, definitely these subjects are very, very important. But along with that, we cannot neglect a paper 2, that is this one. So if you observe here, according to the notification of this year, in a UPSC notification, you will find the paper 2, 200 marks, 2 hours duration. If you observe all these topics, total these topics we can categorize into 3 parts. The first two are related to English related. It's completely the basic English. Whenever you are in this journey, UPSC journey, generally in day-to-day life, we have to read the newspapers for the current affairs point of view or whatever. Generally, we will read editorials. In all these things, definitely whenever you are reading all these things, comprehension questions very easily we can answer, and interpersonal skills, including communication skills. The first two parts are related to English part. It's a completely basic English. You have the minimum idea in the regular English, definitely we can answer these type of question. In the olden days, if you observe the previous year questions of this particular UPSC CSAT paper 2, generally they have to give English grammar related questions also, but day by day, present years, if you observe last 2-3 years papers, they are reducing, but they are giving some kind of analytical type of questions, even in comprehension type of questions also. And clearly we will see about the remaining two parts also, but the most of the non-math students who don't have idea about the maths and reasoning, they are fearing about all these things, but no need to worry. Whatever logics we'll discuss regular classes, definitely these logics will help. If you know the logics, if you know the shortcuts, most of the questions from reasoning and basic maths part, very quickly, very easily we can answer. Easily you can scale through this particular paper 2, CSAT paper 2, easily we can scale, because here if you observe all these topics from logical reasoning, whatever topics we have here, and mathematics part or basic maths, all these topics are very simple. So I'll make you all these topics very simple. I'll give that much clear analysis here. Total topics, what topics are there? The remaining two important parts are logical reasoning and analytical ability, decision making and problem solving, general mental ability. If you observe, these three topics are mainly related to reasoning part. But see, in these terms only they're given in the notification, along with these terms, you'll find so many different type of questions in the actual paper of the exam. So we'll analyze what all other topics. If you observe previous year papers, you'll get complete idea what type of topics regularly they are giving. We'll see all these points. And if you talk about this particular mathematics, in notification itself, clearly UPS mentioned that. So this maths, whatever topics we are focusing here completely is based on 10th class base level only. So no need to worry about that. Even if you're a non-math student or arts background or medical background or whatever, easily we can score. So no need to worry about that. But generally, whenever you are preparing for UPSC in this CSAT, so whichever topics you are good in, that particular, maybe English, maybe reasoning, maybe particular maths. So you select that in which topics you are very good, just focus only on the topic, because in the paper 2, CSAT paper 2, no need to score 200 out of 200 marks, just clearing that qualifying marks 33%. But another important point, just we cannot score. To score that 33% of marks means out of 200, we have to score 66 marks. How to score 66 marks, how many questions we have to attempt, what may be the good number of attempts. Just if you talk about that point, generally, If you attempt very clearly with 100% accurately, 27-28 questions, easily you can score 66 marks. But here, thing is, sometimes some questions may be wrong. So accuracy matters a lot. So that's why better the good number of attempts should be, so more than 40 or 45 questions should be the very good attempt. If you attempt the 45 questions accurately or at least 90% accurately, definitely we can score very good marks. That's why, so any two sections, you have to focus here. Within that two sections, try to score maximum number of marks. That's why today I am giving complete analysis of logical, complete reasoning part and basic mathematic part. Just once you see this individual wise, English, the simple suggestions are generally in day-to-day life, in your preparation strategy, we are reading the newspapers, whatever articles we'll read from editorials, that points are enough. And along with this, if you feel more difficult, just do revision of the previous year questions. Once you see the revision previous year questions, you'll get to know that what level of questions they are giving in English and what type of questions they are giving in English. Very clearly you can understand. So no need to worry about the English. Very easily we can score very good marks from this particular English part. And if you observe the reasoning, these are the important terms they given in the syllabus. But along with this, we have to focus on all these topics. If you observe maybe 2020 paper or maybe 2019 or before that, whatever paper you observe from the reasoning, and these are the topics they are giving regularly. If you observe from every topic, and an average we are getting 1 to 2 marks. If you observe coding decoding, if you observe 2020 paper, they given 2 questions only from coding decoding. Like that, every year they are giving. But if you observe the actual notification of UPSC, they are not mentioned these particular topics, but still all these topics are very, very important, because we are getting questions from coding, decoding, still build relations, direction and distance is very, very important, and series analogy and odd one out. From these topics, regularly they are giving minimum 1 or 2 questions from these 3 topics, as well as syllogisms is very important concept whenever you are talking about UPSC, CSE, CSAT paper 2. Regularly we are getting minimum 2 to 3 questions, and cubes and dice also very simple and easy. We are getting minimum number of questions. If you observe fuzzles, 2019 they given 4 to 5 questions only from fuzzles and seating elements. So observe any topic here, regularly we are getting decision making questions, because once you become an IAS officer or IP officer or any other officer, generally decision making is important in a job profile. That's why decision making questions are important. And all these topics also, logical reasoning part, these points also very, very important. Specifically in a notification also they mentioned logical reasoning topics are obviously important, and some kind of figure related questions, maybe counting figures, mirror image, water image, these kind of counting figure related questions also regularly they are giving. And if you observe last 2-3 years papers, regularly they are giving data sufficiency questions also. Just if you are good in all the above topics, all the data sufficiency questions we can answer very easily. But if you talk about reasoning, what should be the best strategy? What type of books we have to follow? Most of the students regularly they're asking about books. We don't have any special books. We can follow anything. But if you follow my logics regularly, definitely we can score very good marks. The basic points about this particular reasoning, always focus on basic concepts and logics are very, very important. Once you clear with all the logics in all the topics, see, if you observe some topics here, we have very, very good shortcuts and very good logics. If you know that logics, very less time, it takes maybe 30-40 seconds, we can answer some questions. But if you observe this total CSAT paper 2 consists of 80 questions, but we have 2 hours time, that is 120 minutes. Each question carries nearly 1.5 minutes, but we can solve most of the questions from this particular syllabus within 30-40 seconds also, if you know the best logics. That logics will provide from Vishnu IAS Academy. So definitely try to utilize all these content. Definitely we can score very good marks, because say reasoning is not a particular subject related to academy. If you are a maths background or non-maths background or medical arts, whatever it is, definitely you can score. One of the important area is this particular CSAT paper 2 is the reasoning. That area very easily we can score best marks with this Vishnu IAS Academy. The best logics, just utilize that best logics, definitely we can score very, very good marks from the reasoning section. So I hope everyone clear. Only important thing, logics and basic concepts. Once you clear with all these points, just practice some questions. No need to practice n number of questions. Just if you observe the previous year's papers. Just try to solve that previous year papers. You will get complete confidence on this particular reasoning part. Definitely, if you talk about mathematics also, in notification itself, they are telling it's a 10th place level, means definitely if you are a maths background or non-maths background, it's not matter. Very basic type of questions they can ask. So they are giving the basic numeracy, number related questions only they will ask here, or maybe data interpretation type of questions they're asking. Particularly in the syllabus, they mention only these two terms. But if you talk about complete analysis of the syllabus of the maths or quantitative aptitude part, if you observe, these are the topics regularly we are finding in previous year questions of UPSC CSAT paper 2 maths part. Just observe all these topics: number system, HCF, LCM, number series, and percentages, a very important concept here. If you are good in percentages concepts, definitely you can answer so many different type of concepts very easily. But even in maths also, right, even if you are from non-maths background, you can understand very easily that kind of shortcuts, that kind of technique. Sometimes without pen and paper, that means without formulas also, how to answer these type of questions, we will give the complete idea. Because once you take the total CSAT paper 2 very clearly, very easily, you will find some more time to prepare general studies 1. That is very, very important. So obviously we cannot neglect any paper. General studies 1, obviously very, very important. We will give the best logics for this particular maths part also. Without using pen and paper, you can answer maximum number of questions. Without using formulas also, we can answer these type of questions. So we make very easy this particular CSAT paper 2 in your journey. So whenever this CSAT paper 2 is easy for you, you can spend more time for CSAT paper 1, that is general studies 1. That's why, so always vision, Vishnu IAS Academy gives the best logics for the CSAT paper 2. From my side, 100% CSAT paper 2. Maybe it is a reasoning, maybe it is mathematics, definitely we'll try to give 100% the best logics. But just if you follow these logics blindly, you will find more time to prepare general studies 1 also. That's why in your journey, we are making very simple. So if you follow just my classes in Vishnu IAS, 100% you can score very easily in very less time. So that 33% of marks is very simple and cakewalk to you in your UPSC CSE prelims preparation point of view. These are the very, very important points. Just if you talk about books, so no need to take any particular books. So from the Vishnu IAS Academy, we will give the everything that may be related to questions, or that may be related to previous year questions analysis, and that may be related to preparation point of view, logics and everything. So we will give here, no need to purchase any books. So if you talk about standard books, we cannot spend more time just to score 66 marks here. So for that point of view, we cannot make any more time to that particular thing, but just spend more time on this particular classes, 100% you will get the best thing. So thank you friends, thank you all. These are complete details about UPSC preparation, preliminary CSAT paper 2 analysis, syllabus analysis and preparation tips. If you are watching the first time Vishnu IAS Academy, please subscribe to this channel and please share this information to your friends in your groups that may be useful for your friends also. Thank you all. Thank you everyone.